welcome back to another 360 demonstration in the craps table. Okay, we're going to try to mix two strategies today, the Iron Cross, which is my favorite, and then we're going to mix it with the Martingale strategy. And I've never done that in real life on the craps table. I've just seen it done, and I do it here with the fake money. But it's where you, if you lose the 5 on the field, you put 10. If you lose that, you put 20. If you lose that, you put 40. If you lose that, 80, 160, and so forth. And if you have endless amounts of money, it would always work. But we are probably going to cut our losses at 80 because I don't see myself ever putting 160 on a field bet. 80 is pushing it. So anyway, we're going to start off with a bankroll of 320 and see if we can mix those two strategies together and see if it'll pay off. So here we go. We're going to establish the point with the 6 on top, with a 5 on the inside, 4 on top with a 6 on the outside. 6, 4, 6. Here we go. Our point is 8. Which helps me on the Iron Cross. So I'm going to put 5 on the field, 10 on the 5, 10 behind the line, 12 on the 6. Okay, 14 payoff, 5, and then that payoff with the odds behind the line. So here we go. Now we're going to do the 5s on top with the 3s facing me, and hopefully make some money. Okay, so there's a 6-3. It's a field bet. Now remember, if we lose that field, we're going to put $10 down. Okay, there's 11. That's another field bet. Take a $5 bill, put it in your bank. Here we go again. Hard 6, our first loss on the field, but we still get paid because the Iron Cross is in effect. So there's 10, 14 for the... for the 6, lose the field. We're going to put 10 on the field now. Hopefully, we won't have to go much higher than 20. Because that really hits in your bankroll, man, when you start getting 40s and 80s on the field. 4-1. Okay, that pays 14. And now, we have to put 20 on the field. Yeah, I really don't want to have to go to 80. Which is what we're about to... No, sorry, we're going to 40 after this. Okay, that's a 6-2. That's our point. We lost the 20 on the field. So we're going to gain 12 on our pass line. Or, sorry, 5 on the pass line, 12 for our odds. We lost the 20 on the field. So we're going to put 40 there next, but we're going to establish the point first, just in case I roll a 7 here, which is what I'm going for. Okay, 9. Now we're putting 40 on the field. 25, 30, 35, 40. 40 on the field. Oh, and also I got to put 10 on the end. 12 on the 8, sorry. 12 on the 8, 40 on the field, and here we go. I'd love to hit the 9 right about now. Ooh, not good. 3-2. Pays 14 on the 5. Okay, and now we're going to see my heart racing now because we got to have 80. On the field. This is where I'm cutting my losses too, because I'm not putting 160 out there. There is 50, 60, 70, 80. Oh man, here we go. Come on, boxcars. Come on, snake eyes. Can we get paid on this $80 on the field? My heart's racing as if this was real money. Here we go. Please, 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 field. Drum roll, 3-1. Okay. I forgot to pick up my winnings there. 80. We get paid 80. So, there's 50. Hold on. We get paid 80. So, here we go. 50. 60. 70. taking it all back down to $5. So there's, we just won $80 off that field. Good grief, that was scary. Okay, 3-1. Back down to 5. Starting back from scratch. Now I can relax a little bit. Okay, back to a 5, 3, 2. So we gained $14 for that 5 hit. And we lose the field, so we're going to put $10 out there. Okay, there's 11, so that's a field bet. So we gained $10 right back. Drop it back down to a 5. Keep on rolling. Ooh, 7. That was a weird bounce. Okay, so we lose everything. Good thing we only had 5 on the field that time. Oh, that would be bad to roll a 7 with that 80 on there. Okay, so let's do it one more time. I was looking at the time there. Establish a point, and we'll try it one more time, and then we'll see what we got. Okay, 5, 3, 2, 5. That helps out on the iron cross. So we'll put 12 on the 6, 12 on the 8. And we'll put 10 behind the line. And 5 on the field. No, actually, we lost the field that earlier. So now we're going to put 10 on there. Remember, because that 7 knocked out that 5. So now we're putting 10 on the line. On the field. Seven again? Unheard of. Okay, so take that back down. We just stacked it all up. Sometimes that happens, guys. Sometimes it's a cold table. So we're going to try to revamp the table here. Starting over. Just remember, we lost 10 on the field there, so we're going to have to double that to 20. Okay, there's a 10. Well, that really sucks when you're doing the iron cross and you lay everything out there right after you establish the point and then you hit a 7. Okay, so we had 10 on the field, so now we're going to put 20 on the field. We're going to put 10 on the 5, 12 on the 6, 12 on the 8. Okay, oh, and also we need to put some... behind the line. Okay. Got some change there for that 25. All right, here we go. Hard 6. We lose the $20. I have to remember that. We have to lose. We have to put 40 out there now. So we gain $14 from this 6. Okay. 14 from the 6. We lost the 20 on the field. So now we have to put 25, 30, 35, 40. $40 on the field. Back almost in that same situation again. All right, here we go. I'm really hoping for a field bet. No, we're going back to 80 again. That's 3-2. That's the exact same thing we did earlier, isn't it? 14. At 14, and now we're putting 80. There's 50, 75, 80. Okay, 80 on the line. This better be a field bet, or we're toast. Ah, couldn't have written a better script. 6-4. That was our point plus our 80. So we just gained another 80. And we got the point, which is 10 behind the line. Sorry, double, 2-1 behind the line, and 5 on the line. Man, that definitely helped. Okay, points off. We're going to run through one more time. I think we have just enough time to do one more time. Let's establish the point. Or not. Snake eyes. Lose the pass line. And we put another five out there. Okay, there's our five as our point. Put 10 behind the line. And remember, we won that 80, so the field goes back down to five. So, here we go. Then we are now, we've got the point of five, so we're going to establish the, we've already established the point, sorry I got distracted. We are, point is five, and we're now rolling with a dice set of fives on top with the threes. Okay, we got an eight. 5-3. Okay, that pays 14. There, we lose the field. We're going to put 10 down there on the field now. Okay, here we go. Whoa. 12. So we get paid double for that. Because even though it says triple, where I play, it only pays double. So we'll just take that. We'll take it back down to 5. Okay. As soon as we hit this point or we hit 7 out, we're going to call it quits and see what we got. Off the wall. Bad throw. Man, it's really hard to, you know, make your exact throw the same every time, but we're trying. Okay, so that is a field bet. $5 in our bank. Oh, we're getting sloppy now. Hard 4, field bet. You know it's a bad throw when you throw it to one end of the table and the dice end up at the back at the same place it started. All right, we 7'd out. Everything was going downhill from there anyway. All right, 7. So we lose all this. So let's add up really quick. Remember, we started with 320. And see if we made a profit doing the mixture of both strategies here. Okay. Here we go. 100. Never even had to cash this in, so that's 200. 250. 275, 300, that's 300, it's a 20, so it's 320, we got back to exactly what we started with there, so all this is profit, 10, 20, 30, $5, and there's 40, $47. We have $47 in profit. That whole roll only gained us $47 profit. But in my book, it's a profit, and you had fun rolling. So anyway, that's two strategies mixed together, and I'll talk to you guys later.